Come here.
Nora.
Hi, Paige.
What are you doing here? Didn't I just leave you and Daniel at home?
Yeah. I needed to come here and try and make some sense out of this.
Well, I'm glad you have Daniel to help you through all of this.
Where is he?
Where is she? Where's Jen?
Coroner has already taken her.
Commissioner, do you think that this has anything at all to do with the Killing Club?
We don't know anything for sure yet.
We know exactly what happened with Jen. She took her own life because she couldn't live with herself for killing Paul.
And that makes it all real neat and tidy for you, doesn't it? How can you be so sure?
We got her.
An angel, and I appreciate it so very much.
You think I wanted any of this to happen? My son is devastated. We all are. Jen may have shot Paul, but she's not a killer. She did what she did, for whatever the reason, it was tearing her up inside.
If she killed Kramer.
Why else would she commit suicide?
Maybe because she was going to prison for something that she didn't do.
Come on, let's go.
I assume Marianne is at home?
Yeah, she's with Matthew. Listen, I didn't want you to misunderstand about the governor's phone call tonight.
You know what, Daniel? I'm not really interested in understanding you or your political ambitions right now. What I am trying desperately to understand is why a young girl who had everything to live for, a young girl who I loved very much, decided to take her life tonight.
Why didn't you tell me about this?
Excuse me, you are?
God, please don't do this right now. I need you. Jim was a good friend of mine.
Excuse me, Mr. Solomon. I'm sorry about your friend, but this is an ongoing investigation, and I really can't discuss it.
Hey, I got your back on this.
Well, I think I've got it covered.
This one's personal for you, Bo. Sometimes that makes it difficult to see clearly.
Yeah, but your plate's full right now with the Killing Club murders.
Not so full.
Thanks. Why don't you take a look around?
Okay.
That couldn't have been easy for you.
What?
Admitting that you need help.
I guess we all do from time to time.
That's why I'm here.
I need to talk to you.
Wait a second. What's going on?
I think I found something that could tell us who Ted is. This is what happens when you keep secrets, man. Always messes with you in the end.
We already searched Kramer's things.
Yeah, but nobody knew about Ted back then. Check this out.
Ted D. 15,000.
It's gotta be bucks, right? And Kramer was doing late night pickups for this Ted, and now we know his last name starts with a D.
Yo, that narrows the field, but it's still not enough.
Yeah, but we're closing in, right?
What do you got? Okay, thanks. Bad news. It looks like Coulson may have been right about Jen killing Kramer. We've got proof.
Bailey.
The bandana we found in Jen's car had Kramer's blood on it.
I just don't understand. I mean, this bandana showing up after all this time, after it had been searched.
Maybe she hid it somewhere.
Where? He looked everywhere. It was planted by this Ted D. That's who offed Kramer, and that's the one who killed Jen. And I swear, he better hope that you find him before I do. Because I'm gonna tear the son of a bitch apart who did this to my girl.
Excuse me.
I just came to express my sympathies and to let you know the governor's office will do anything we can to help.
I'm so glad my husband has the support of the governor's office.
Well, take care. I'll let myself out.
Thanks. Thanks again, Bailey. Nora, listen, about earlier tonight, I'm sorry about Jen. I'm looking at her as a case, and I should be looking at her as something.
You know what? I don't want to talk about Jen. There's something else I want to know.
What?
Are you having an affair?